A federal high court in Abuja has fixed November 8th for judgment in the 2.1 billion naira fraud suit against Abdul Rashid Maina, the former chairman of the defunct Pension Reform Task Team. Hi, welcome to What's Happening. These are the top 10 stories now. At number 10, 187 kidnapped persons were rescued by security agents on Thursday during raids on the dwellings of bandits in Sibiri Forest in Maradun local government area of Zamfara State. The police spokesperson in the state, Mohammed Shehu, disclosed this in a statement issued in Gusau on Thursday. Shehu said the rescued victims, which comprise of males, female adults and children, have been handed over to the state government. He said today, 7th October 2021, police tactical operatives in a joint operation at Sibiri Forest in Maradun local government area of the state succeeded in the unconditional rescue of 187 victims abducted in Wini, Gora, Sambonbini and Shinkafi communities in Bakura, Maradun and Shinkafi local government areas respectively. The abducted victims, who had spent many weeks in captivity, were unconditionally rescued following extensive search and rescue operations that lasted for hours. At number 9, the army has released popular Nollywood actor Chinweta Loagu a day after arresting and detaining him for putting on an outfit with semblance to the Biafran flag. Agu's release was made known via a video posted by Nollywood actor Emeka Ike on his Instagram page on Friday, where Agu was filmed with two representatives from the Actors Guild of Nigeria. Agu was set to be released due to the intervention of the AGN. According to one of the representatives, the actor is hale and hearty. At number 8, the special advisor to President Muhammadu Buhari on media and publicity, Femi Adesina, has stated that the Senate minority leader, Senator Eyinaya Abaribe, ought to be cooling off his feet in prison after he stood shorty for someone bent on dismemberment of the country. Abaribe, a People's Democratic Party senator from Abia State, stood as shorty for Nnamdi Kanu, the leader of the indigenous people of Biafra, before he jumped bail in 2017. Adesina, in a Facebook piece on Thursday night, knocked Abaribe for allegedly using foul language against those in leadership. Although he neither mentioned the name of Abaribe nor Kanu's, it was clear that he was referring to the duo. At number 7, the Central Bank of Nigeria has disbursed the sum of 343.22 billion naira to 726,198 beneficiaries through the targeted credit facility. The beneficiaries comprise of 702,730 households and 123,468 small and medium enterprises. CBN Governor Godwin Emefiele, who made this known while speaking at a conference in Abuja on Thursday, also assured that eNaira, whose launch was suspended on October 1st, would be inaugurated in a few days. He added that the launch will make Nigeria one of the countries in Africa and indeed the globe to digitize its national currency. At number 6, Kano State Government says over 18 workers in the mainstream civil service had retired from the state service, while 187 others were promoted in the month of September 2021 respectively. The chairman of the State Civil Service Commission, Bello Mohammed Kiru, disclosed this on Thursday shortly after the commission's routine meeting for senior staff promotion exercise held at the conference hall of the commission. Kiru further explained that those retired from the service of the state government were senior and junior staff due to age or reaching the 35 years in active service. At number 5, a powerful earthquake struck Tokyo on Thursday night, leaving 32 people injured. The earthquake also disrupted train services on Friday morning, affecting around 368,000 passengers. East Japan Railway Co. said the strongest earthquake paused services on the Shinkansen bullet train and 16 local train lines were cancelled or delayed. It said many passengers were forced to wait at stations due to delays. At number 4, the Director General of the Budget Office of the Federation, Ben Akabueze, has said that the 2022 budget figure proposed by President Muhammadu Buhari is low. Akabueze said this while speaking on Channel's television program Politics Today on Thursday. Buhari presented a total budget of 16.39 trillion naira to the joint session of the National Assembly on Thursday. The figure is the highest in the country's history and over 3 trillion naira more than the 2021 budget. However, Akabueze, a leading person in the budget preparation, said the federal budget is so low compared to the country's unmet needs. At number 3, the police in Imo State say they have arrested one of the kingpins of the indigenous people of Biafra, Uche Nachukwu, in Imo State. The police spokesman in the state, Mike Abatam, said in a statement issued in Owerri on Friday that the IPOB kingpin was arrested at Eyimemba non-local government area. Abatam explained that the police also killed an IPOB member who joined other members to frustrate the kingpin's arrest. He further stated that the police stormed Chukwu's shop in the Eyimemba non area following credible information to arrest him. At number 2, the Abuja Division of the Federal High Court has fined a former registrar of the Joint Admissions and Matriculation Board, Dibu Ojerinde, 100,000 naira over his plea for an adjournment of the commencement of his trial. Justice Obiora Eguatu gave the order on Friday after counsel to the Independent Corrupt Practices and Other Offences Commission, Ebenezer Shogunle, prayed for an award of a fine in favour of one of the commission's witnesses who travelled from Ibadan to testify in the money laundering trial. Finally, at number 1, a federal high court in Abuja has fixed November 8th for judgment in the 2.1 billion naira fraud suit against Abdul Rashid Maina, the former chairman of the defunct pension reform tax team. Recall that the Economic and Financial Crimes Commission had on October 25, 2019, arraigned Maina alongside his firm, Common Impute Property and Investment Limited, before Justice Okon Abang. The former pension boss had pleaded not guilty to the 12-count charge bordering on money laundering to the tune of 2 billion naira. Announcing the date for judgment on Friday, Justice Abang fixed November 8th for hearing. Always remember to wear your mask, wash your hands, and stay safe. That's all for today. See you next time on What's Happening.